7, take what he saw his father jumping up and down, waving a piece of cloth. Sam went then up on the tree, and his father ran to him, and his father wrapped his arms around him, and tears of joy just flooded down. Father, we give thanks, Father, because you are the one, Father. possess the great teacher, but we have said the book, ourselves as well as we did, see, when you think about it, God the Father is the perfect Father. God the Father is the perfect Father. The one thing God is doing for us all is that we all have the Father. We have the Father. But you ask me, of God as Father, as Vice Father, whether he would be the Father. For some people, they might not even know who their father is. But when you see Father's Day is not a good day, it's a tough day, it's a hard day. We're not people who might fight this day. Because of the endeavors that they have with their father, the Holy Rescue, and abused and rejected by them, they went where they did not be working for us, they reached it by growing up in a false. Of some girls who are mostly parents by their parents, it takes a lot of time to help these young people to heal, to show them a background picture of a loving father. And the only way that we can point them to the Father, to change their view of the Father, is point them to the Heavenly Father. And it was only then that they found complete healing in the lives that we did as well. We are children of God. Do you look at him as Father, or do you struggle with him? In 1 John 3, 1, it tells us, see what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. But that is what we are, as he says. His love for us is a measurement of the love that the Father has come to us through Jesus, his Son. And Paul in Ephesians says this, he kneels before the Father and prays that we may grasp how wide, how long, how deep is the love of Christ. And I love John Stuart puts it this way, the love of God is broad enough to encompass all mankind. The love of God is long enough to last eternity. The love of God is deep enough to reach the most degraded sinner. What then is our response for the Father's love? What is our response? When do we come to this world? If you want to turn to Deuteronomy 6, I have a look at that. Okay. You see, our belief, this says about Deuteronomy, is an exposition of exposing or expounding what is said on the Ten Commandments for Moses. Chapter 6 to 18, Moses is applying the first four commandments, telling them the people of Israel the details of how to love the Lord their God, how to love the Lord their God. You might be asking at this point, such the bad as the shadow. This is the true response to Judaism. They recite this twice a day to remind them of their commitment to God. Perhaps they verbalize by a breath that would help them have these words about their lips as they die. The sight of God. Jesus referred to this as the greatest commandment. But in Matthew 22, he is questioned, "Teacher, which of the greatest commandments of the law?" Jesus replied, "You love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and the greatest commandment." But Jesus added to this Leviticus 19, "This is where it kills you, and the second is like your love your neighbor as yourself." All the law of the prophets hang on these 10 commandments. Everything hangs on these 10 commandments. Shalom means to listen, obey. If you didn't obey, you didn't listen. It's like calling the kids in the shop and if they come in, when they don't come in, you know they heard you. But they didn't listen. You see, it means to respond here. You hear God's calls, and sometimes you don't listen to them. It means you don't hear them. Here, Shalom, on this rock, on all our God, the Lord is one. Yahweh was the sole object of Israel's worship, allegiance, and affection. The word one, or more or the one, is polytheism. There is only one God. However, as we know, Judges, the book of Judges, they actually fell away from this. They didn't actually reject God. They actually put God down. Other gods beside them, and the worship of love, Western syncretic worship. It's God being disciplined, what God said in the Ten Commandments. And it's a commandment today that we are to commit ourselves to the worship of God. When we declare that together, don't we? The creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty. I respond to them, how is it to be? Is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. The heart in Hebrew is lev, yeah. It actually means mind. Some people will try to separate the heart and the mind. But in the Bible, it's the same. The heart is your cognitive abilities to process your thoughts. It's the will, it's the heart of having a plan to put plans into action. It's center, it's the will, yeah. To love is not just when you feel like it, but love is when, you know, even when you don't feel those emotions, you still love. You see, I still love my wife, even when I'm having a hard time. And you see, I must still love God even when He's raised my heart. He said, well, I must still love this God, no matter what the circumstances. Don't let your emotions be. Paul says, we take captive every thought and we make it obedient to Christ. So let the Lord call your soul. You know, the songs of the past, sometimes in his patience, but you see, the Jewish interpretation of soul is nefesh. Nefesh means life. We are to love God. We are to love the Lord with all our lives, with every part of our life. It's not only weekends or our 5 minutes, not that we might differ. The Lord, we are to love the Lord in everything we do. He is never far from you. He is never to be far from your thoughts or your deeds. The idea is that we should love God in every point of our lives, even sacrifice our lives for Him. You are to walk with Him, talk with Him, act for Him. You are to walk, talk, and act for Him. So let the Lord with all your strength. The Hebrew translation for that is build. You can say that, right? troubles there are in you today are to be on your hearts and wondering. They are to be embedded so that nothing can erase them. It's to be when your hearts are fresh on the spot. 2 Corinthians, Paul says, you yourselves are a letter written on your hearts. Your own being read by everyone. You show that you are the letter from Christ. Of our ministry, written not with me, but with the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human flesh. You see, this is the first commandment for the Father to be connected to the Heavenly Father. The next self of all of us, the very next day, you see, the next one becomes a person in Christ. Says to teach them diligently. The greatest teacher, Jesus, did just that. In John 15, he says, I have taught you everything the Father has told me. In other words, he impressed upon us, the apostles, everything that the Father had taught me, he impressed upon them. He impressed them on your children. He made an impression on them. They were strong and lasting. states, but I was talking about the web of the home, where children, so it's kind of like his own, just does what he wants, just give his own command, you know, but this show is kind of where his own, and this world happens. But just because God's trying to make bad choices, that doesn't mean it's the same. Says, I just quickly glance through it because I have to finish. 5 ways every Christian can play a part in the pray to be involved in any prayer initiatives and pray for these children and to encourage them and reassure them that whatever you've been praying for, they are fencing children and young people spot the faith that they don't really speak in their being faith. Share your challenges and failures as a whole. Thank you. suffering.